Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel MP Learners. I am your instructor Mahesh Tahir and today's topic is the hexadecimal system. After giving you introduction, I will show you how to convert binary numbers into hexadecimal and then hexadecimal numbers into binary numbers. So first of all, let's have some introduction. The hexadecimal system is very closely related to the binary system. Sometimes it is also referred to as hex. And it is a base 16 system, which means it uses 16 different values to represent each digit. From 0 to 9 digits are used, and when after 9, when digits become 2 digits numbers, so we'll be using alphabets instead of using 2 digits number. So from 10 to 15 we'll be using values from A to F. Now as I've shown you the table for binary and dandy numbers, in case of binary, the table was using 2 to the raised to power 0, 2 to the raised to power 1, 2 to the raised to power 2, and so on. And in case of dandy, the table was using 10 to the raised to power 0, 10 to the raised to power 1, 10 to the raised to power 2, and so on. Now, in case of hexadecimal, this table is using 16. To the raised to power 0, 16 to the raised to power 1, 16 to the raised to power 2, and so on. And when we calculate the values, we will be getting 1, 16, 256, 4096, and 65536. What is the link between binary and hexadecimal numbers? We can see that 2 to the raised to power 4 is equivalent to 16. So here is the base we are using is 16. We can say that 2 to the raised to power 4 is the binary number that is representing a hexadecimal number, which means 4 bits will be representing a hexadecimal digit, as you can see in this table. 2 to the raised to power 0, 2 to the raised to power 1, 2 to the raised to power 2, 2 to the raised to power 3. All of these columns are using binary numbers. So 1, 2, 4, 8, if we sum up all of these values, we will be getting 15, which is the highest value in case of hexadecimal, and the lowest value is 0. So 0 to 15 are the numbers in case of hexadecimal. Now, what is the link between binary and hexadecimal and dandy numbers? So to show this link, I will be showing you a table. In this table, we have three columns. One is representing binary value, other one is hexadecimal, and the third one is representing dandy values. If we can see, here dandy values are starting from 0 and ending at 15, which means total 16 values are used. And in case of hexadecimal value, values are starting from 0 until 9. These are same as dandy value, but when it comes at 10, it becomes A. Then at 11, it is C, B. At 12, it is C. At 13, it is D. At 14, it is E, and then at 15, it is F. So these are the hexadecimal values that are equivalent to these dandy values. Now, how to calculate these 4-bit binary values for each hexadecimal value? To calculate these values, I can show you a simple method by using the table that I have shown you in the previous slide. This table. So here we can see values are 1, 2, 4, and 8. So starting from the right side, the value is 1, so I will be writing 1, 0, then 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, and so on till 1. In the next column, as the value is 2, so I will be writing 2 zeros, 2 ones, 2 zeros, 2 ones, and so on. In the third column, the value is 4, so I will be writing 4 zeros, 4 ones, 4 zeros, and 4 ones. And then it's 8, so 8 zeros and 8 ones. This is the simplest method to create a table for hexadecimal values that are having binary values. Now converting from binary numbers to hexadecimal, starting from the right and moving towards left, split the binary number into groups of 4 bits, and then if the last group has less than 4 bits, then simply fill in the zeros from the left sides. As you know that if you add 0 at the left side, it will not change the number, so you can add as many zeros as you want. Take each group of 4 bits and convert it into equivalent hexadecimal number using the table that I have shown you in the previous slide. Now, using table values, I will show you an example. Convert this binary number into hexadecimal. For this, first step is split the bits from right side, and it will be having 4 bits in each group like this. First group is having 0001, then 1110, then 1011. If you can see the table, it will be showing you this value is equivalent to 1, this value is equivalent to E, and this value is equivalent to B. Now, if you don't want to use a table, you can simply calculate these values without using the table. So I will be showing you same example without using the table values. So first step is same, that is split the bits from right into groups of 4 bits. And after splitting, use the table that I have shown you, 4-bit table that I have shown you in the previous slide. And the 4-bit groups that you have created, simply place these numbers in the sequence like 0, 0. Under 4, you will be writing this 0, and then 0, 0, 1, 1. When we will sum up all the bits that are having value 1, we will be getting the appropriate value for that specific binary number, 4-digit binary number. So here I have 1. In this part, 8 plus 4 plus 2 equals to 14, that is E. Then 8 plus 2 plus 1 equals to 11, that is equivalent to B. So this hexadecimal number is exactly the same data I have shown you in the previous slide. You can see here BE1 and then BE1. So both of these methods are very easy. You can use any of them. And now we can see another example, that is 10111011011. It's the binary number and you need to convert it into hexadecimal. First step is the same, that is split the bits from right into groups of 4 bits. And you can see here after splitting, there are 2 numbers in the last group, so you will add 2 zeros at the left side to complete the 4-bit number. So after using the values from the table, you can see the answer is 2E6D, that is hexadecimal equivalent of this binary value. You can also solve this example using without table values, so you can try it. And now let's move towards converting numbers from hexadecimal to binary. In this case, you can also use both methods, that is table values and without using the table values. Firstly, I will show you using the table values. Convert 5A6 hexadecimal number into binary number. And using table values, if we see 5 is equal to 0101, A is equals to 1010, 6 is equals to 0110. So what's the method to write this? These numbers into a sequence, you will simply place all the 4 bits that are for 5, then for A here, and then for 6 here. So sequence will be followed to complete this binary number. This binary number is equivalent to 5A6. Now example 2 is shown again without using the table values. Here you have to convert 5A6 hexadecimal number into binary number. So to complete a 5, you will simply place 1s on that places that will be giving you the result 5. So I have placed 1 under 4 and then 1. 4 plus 1 equals to 5, which means this one is the binary equivalent of 5. Now repeat the same step for A, that is write 1 under 8 and under 2. So after adding up 8 and 2, you will get 10, that is A. And in the last, for 6, you have to turn on bit 4 and 2. And when we will sum up, 4 plus 2 is equal to 6. And writing these bits in a sequence will be giving you this binary number, that is equivalent of this hexadecimal number. That was all for today, and I have shown you methods to convert hexadecimal numbers into binary numbers and binary numbers into hexadecimal numbers. I hope you understood both of the methods and examples very easily. And for now, thank you for watching my video. Take care. Goodbye.